know what he would have worked with, so we'll see if he remembers any of that from this morning. So we're just going to touch his shoulder and see if he wants to move that. Good boy. Think. So I'm just going to keep doing it and get a little bit louder until, there you go, until he makes a move. Good boy. And then I'm going to let him process it a minute. And it's not about speed. So I rarely use the whip to add energy. I rather use the whip for direction and to get going or to back up an aid I've already asked for. So either on the ground or under saddle, I don't use the whip for energy. So here I would just tell him, hey, let's try that again. First I look at his shoulder. Then I point the whip at it. So he's had two signals from me. My energy's at his shoulder. Now I'm telling him, hey, let's move that again. And there he stares out the wilderness. And now he's like trying to tune me out, but I'm bugging him. So he's starting to think about it, but he's like, I don't know. How long is he going to take until I get loud enough that he decides what he should do? He has to decide. Move your shoulder over. Yes, you will. Good boy. And the second he did it, I leave him alone.